If you love artificial intelligence, or AI, you're going to love no code. So AI allows us to communicate with some sort of fake entity, some computer entity, and get some feedback, get some information pulled back from our prompt. But no code tools allow us to essentially build applications that don't require any code at all. What happens when we mix these two things together? Well, that's exactly what we're talking about in this video, because I'm going to show you how Softr.io has already built native integrations with OpenAI. This is really cool stuff, because now we're talking about machine learning combined with no-code tools. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I own Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. At the forefront of no-code tools is Softr.io, which allows us to build a web application, a front-end portal that interacts with our no-code data sources. And of course, Softr itself is a no-code solution, putting it firmly in the no-code category. But before we actually get into the heart of the video, I want to invite you to check out my free automation training. This is basically the golden goose of no code. Automation allows us to build repeatable tasks that can run in the background, transferring data back and forth, creating documents, invoices, emails, all kinds of magical stuff that you do on repeat every day. You can wipe all that out because you can build a computer program to do it for you. I'm going to teach you all of the fundamentals of automation in no code inside of that training. So be sure to check it out at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. But without further ado, let's hop on into the number one part of Softr's OpenAI integration. Now, this is pretty cool stuff because we can basically call out to OpenAI and say, hey, I need some help. Come up with a fun idea for me as I build my web app. So let's go ahead and hop on into my screen. I'm in an example here where I am looking at a client portal, and this is a template that's available on Softr's website. If you're interested, you can go ahead and access the templates, start from scratch, and basically just build that up and just have this very thing. So once inside of here, what I'm looking to do is add or adapt any of these blocks. So these are the different parts in my web app that I say, hey, I want to put in a inquiry request, or I want to include a couple of different images here, or I want to have a little hero element on this web app. Well, when I'm building this, maybe I'm getting a little stuck. Maybe I'm in the middle of building and I'm writing some stuff, and you know, the default of this template says Grow Lab is a creative growth agency. Well, when I take this template and I make it my own, I'm going to need to obviously update that copy or that text. How do I do that? I'm not the best copywriter, I'll be honest with you, but I would love to leverage some AI. So all I have to do is go into this little text element, and right here I get the friendly robot face. Go ahead and click on friendly robot man, and here we have the ability to just enter a prompt. So maybe what I'm doing here is write intro to no code services. Okay, let's go ahead and see what the AI comes up with. So I've given it this prompt, and look what it tells me. No-code services are revolutionizing the way businesses create and manage what? Well, it looks like it dropped off. It ran out of some steam, but this is a really good start. I mean, we've got some copy automatically added for us that is able now to just be added to our app. So if we were happy with this copy, we could just go ahead and boom, click add to app, and there it is. Now, probably one of the reasons it cut it off is because this is way too long for this little tiny piece right here. So maybe we should try again. We'll hover over to Smiley Robot Face and say, talk about no code benefits in less than 5 words. Let's try this. See if we can get a better response back. There we go. Faster development, lower costs. That's no code in a nutshell. And I didn't have to do any of the hard thinking because, let's be honest, copywriting, as I said, it's not my forte. So let's go ahead and pop that into the app. That looks a lot better, and I'm much happier with these results. So this is one of the ways that you can leverage OpenAI inside of building your Softr web apps. But I can also do the same thing for images. So right here, I have this image of the bar graphs. Again, this came with the template, but maybe I want to replace it. I can hover over into my image, say update, and here I go, another smiling robot, asset generator. Let's tell it about what we want in this image. So I want to see no code consultants helping others. I don't know if this will work, but let's give it a try. The AI seemed pretty smart so far. I'm gonna go ahead and wait. Of course, the image generator, I should warn you, is gonna take a little bit more time. And here we go, we've got some actual stuff back. I don't love either of these because they have words or the attempt at words. Of course, when we use images inside of OpenAI, it doesn't always understand language. And so it's gonna give us stuff that looks like words that really isn't words. So I wouldn't use either of these assets. Maybe I could say no code consultants without any language. I don't know if that'll help us any better, but we can try that again. And as you'll find, as you use OpenAI more and more, you're gonna personally get better at writing stuff that suits the artificial intelligence. So we have to learn how to be better communicators ourselves so that we can set up the proper prompt. I still don't love either of the options that have come back here because I still have all this jibber jabber that doesn't make any sense. But let's imagine that I found an asset that I loved. You can go ahead and click it and add it then to your web app as you see here. And of course, I would need to reorganize the way that this is showing up. So right now, do I want it on repeat? Do I want it as a cover or just to auto or, contain it within a certain section? So you have customization of how you want to display this particular image. But the point is that you can go to OpenAI directly inside of Softr without having to build any kind of complex integration right inside the tool and say, help me write my copy or text. Help me generate my images. Thank you so much. Put it right into your web app. One or two simple clicks. Now that's only the first half of how OpenAI is now available inside of Softr. The other way is actually we can add our new blocks. So if I were to add a block to this particular application, I can come in here, look at my static blocks, and it's a little hard to find. We have to scroll all the way down to the bottom and we have artificial intelligence right here. So we've got a couple of options. I'll go one at a time. We can add in the text generator directly into our app. Previously, I was using the builder, the OpenAI, inside of the web app builder itself. So as I'm designing my application, I'm using OpenAI to either produce copy or images. Well, the difference here is this is a block that we can just drop right into our application. So now that means that our users can interact with AI as well. They can give the text generator a prompt. They can ask for an image inside of the image generator. So let's add both of these now to our web app. Here's the text generator, and I can go ahead and then go back to add the other block, go back over to static, artificial intelligence is at the bottom, and drop in the image generator as well. So now that I have these elements added to my application inside of Softr, now I have to go ahead and build the integration. So flip on over to your settings over on the left-hand side, find integrations from the menu, scroll all the way down, and now integrate with OpenAI. So you're gonna need to copy your OpenAPI key and paste it in, and this way you are gonna be billed for any of the API queries against that OpenAI inside of your Softr application. Don't let that freak you out. It's actually really inexpensive. I think it's about 2 cents per 1,000 tokens that are spent. So you can definitely afford to do a lot of AI querying and not pay a huge, huge bill on that. But now you have the ability to add the AI elements directly inside of a web app that you're building so that people using your application, your users, can directly interact with that AI, whether for text or for image requests. And you can imagine how much more power you're now putting in the hands of your users, all thanks to Softr's integration with OpenAI. Hey, I know we went fast in this video, so if you have any questions, be sure to drop them below. And of course, if you haven't already subscribed, consider subscribing to the channel so that you don't miss out on future videos just like this, all about no code. That's it for this one. I look forward to seeing you in the next video. As always, I hope you found this to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website to see how we can help. We offer an exclusive free training that teaches the fundamentals of no-code tools, including automation. We also have some paid services available, including advanced courses, no-code hourly consulting, as well as custom project consulting. So swing on by to get the help you need, and we look forward to connecting with you soon.